drinking, laughing, having fun, and a truck happened to hit the car, and the friend, her best friend, had died. They just got back on good terms and everything. And because they were drinking and having a lot too much fun at the time, you know, they were college students and all this other stuff, her friend ended up dying. And, you know, it put her in a bad state of mind because, you know, she had to live with that. So.
That's sad.
And we have a caller.
Yeah, let's up.
Caller.
Hello?
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 What's your name, caller?
Daniel.
Chris.
Chris.
I want to answer a trivia cancer.
Oh, question. Trivia cancer. Trivia cancer.
Excuse me, sir.
Okay. All right, Chris. Okay. This is a true. No, not a true or false question. It's an A through E. So I'm going to read off the answers. People who are being abused, A, never admit to themselves. B, often hope or believe the violence won't happen again. C, feel secure. D, feel it is not their fault. Or E, all of the above.
I'm going to go with E.
Oh, you got that right, Chris. Oh, my gosh.
Yay. Why you think that?
All right. Speak on it.
Yeah, why you think
it's E? Speak on it, Chris.
I don't know.
It's explanatory. Look, like, usually explain yourself.
Usually when the answer say all of the above, it's right, usually all of the above. So you just pick it.
Have you ever experienced domestic violence, Chris?
Mm-mm.
I wish somebody would kiss me, man. I promise you.
No.
Be quiet. I promise you. Okay. Well, Chris, thanks for calling in. OCC, you just won a giant can of Tootsie Rolls.
Nakia gonna give it to you.
Y'all are embarrassing. I would just say that.
Chris, can we get you to say, I'm happy to be thug and drug free?
All right.
How you gonna hang up, Chris? What?
If you are still considering donating to our college store, it's not too early nor too late. Donations can still be made online at stepstoday.wix.com/stepsradio. Online donations are being accepted 24/7.
Do you really want to live to see your children and your children's children graduate from high school? Then don't text and drive. It really can wait. Like, for
it
real.
Really can. You don't have to do that.
Caller. Another report.
Oh, okay.
Upon me. You wouldn't believe my real testimony. Can't imagine. Ray Rice was wrong. It was overkill. He ain't have to knock that girl out. But let me tell you this, we better have a conversation in America about teaching our daughters to keep their hands to themselves. There cannot be a double standard there if we love our daughters. Me personally, I was involved in a situation where I was stabbed 5 times by my mate, and she never went to the penitentiary or nothing. And I just think that's crazy, because I know if any man stabs his woman 5 times in America, he's going to jail. After she got through her court proceedings and got off probation without paying the reparations, my doctor bills I had to pay as a single father going through that ordeal with my child, I had to go through a family court proceedings for 5 years that took all my money and my ability to take care of my children to defend myself about who was the better parent against a convicted felon, which I'm not a felon.
We are back. So what y'all think about that report?
Crazy. He stayed around to get stabbed five times.
I would have.
You wouldn't have been able to get close to me.
The second she threatened to stab me, I'm gone.
With a knife. That's what I'm saying. Like, you're crazy.
I'm hit that sign.
It is a double standard there because of the gender. Like, males seem to, like, you know, they think males are more in domestic violence. But some females, you know.
We have another caller
for these two.
So caller, you on the line with the official Pushback Show. What's your name? It's for our special guest. What's your name, caller?
Hi, my name is Barbara.
Hey, Barbara.
Hi, I was really impressed by the 11-year-olds you was interviewing earlier.
Uh-huh.
I was, too.
I just wanted to tell them how encouraging they are and how beautiful they sounded. I was like, I just wanted to know, where do you girls go to for your training?
We go to Star Factory. It's development for stage presence and singing and dancing.
Awesome. And I would like, if it's possible, I'd like to hear their song again, because I couldn't really hear it.
Is it possible that we can play their song?
Yeah, we'll get it on there next week for sure. We will get it back on. You're definitely going to hear more from them. And follow them on Facebook. Micah, what's that Facebook page again?
Micah and Kamila at MYCAHN.
KAMILAH.
And if they can't hear it, then they can hear it on YouTube. What is the name?
Beauty Fascinatastic.
Caller, can we get you to say you're happy to be thug and drug free?
I'm happy to be thug and drug free.
Thank you. Okay, this saying says drinking and driving is like giving your life the middle finger. That is so true.
Yeah.
Right. Drinking and driving is like giving your life the middle finger. Just like, you know what? I don't even care no more. Yeah. I want to die, basically.
Yeah, you know, that's how some people get.
If you're drunk, it's tons of, you don't got a job. I go to sleep in my car if I'm that drunk before I drive somewhere and go home. Yeah.
Drinking and driving is like giving your life the middle finger and others. Not just you.
Thanks, Lonnie.
Thank you, Lonnie.
On the phone. Lonnie.
Right, yeah. You do your job. We doing ours.
Trey.
Anyway.
Shay.
Like your Sunday.
Okay, do y'all want to answer some trivia questions?
Sure.
I do.
Waste time.
Let's waste time. Oh, crap. Okay. One. It's a true or false. Most cases of domestic violence are never reported to the police. Didn't they just answer this question?
That's true.
Yeah, it's true. They just answered this question up in here. Another report.
I was calling about the domestic violence that's going on. I just wanted to say I do not tolerate it. My name is Keita. I think it's wrong for a man to hit a woman. There, under no circumstances, a man should hit a woman. I just do not believe in domestic violence, and I believe that if a man hit a woman once, he will hit her again. And the woman needs to get out of that relationship as soon as possible. A woman is more closely to death when she's in a domestic violence situation, because a man feels like if he can't have her, no one can. And that's just my take on domestic violence. And I'm happy to say I'm drug and thug free.
And we are back. That report. Domestic violence goes both ways, not just a male hitting a female. A woman can beat on a man too, and he, you know, can't do nothing.
It's some strong girls out there, you know.
Yeah, I kind of agree with her though, because you know, some men, they don't like sharing, because you know, they be crazy for real. But you know, women, they crazy too, because they only want that man. But
yeah, you get the right one to try and hit on.
It goes both ways. It's a double standard there on a male hitting a female.
But it's not right either way, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Don't put your hands on me, and I won't put my hands on you.
Nobody should hit anybody, period.
Unless it's... No hitting. No hitting. Sorry.
Nope, no hitting at all.
Yep, that's bad for you. My bad.
No hitting.
Yeah, but I can do one more talking point.
One more.
Okay, it says, what happens to the victims of domestic violence? Domestic violence is the third leading cause of homelessness among families, according to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development.
Domestic violence causing homelessness? That's kind of true. That's true. Oh my goodness.
Oh my God, can you go into depth with that?
Please.
Domestic violence and homelessness. Become homeless after being.
Oh, we have a call.
Another report?
No, a report.
That's disrespectful,
okay.
Man.
We.
Attack the blacks because I know they lack exact the cold facts and still they try to fear us.
Judge. Where do you get off making a decision a child should not see the father?
Justice with conviction. Judge Jeanine Pirro.
did you stab him?
No, Your Honor, what I did was I was yelling, I was going, you better get away like this, and I was going like this, and he goes, ah, ha, ha, and then he's like stepped into it. I was going like this.
Did not step into it.
Plaintiff Monica Armendariz is suing her ex-boyfriend for the cost of a domestic violence class she was ordered to take after she was arrested for stabbing the defendant.
To be fair, did you step into the knife?
No, I did not. The next morning when I went back to my place, she grabbed the phone.
And we are back.
I don't need you.
Oh, we got to call her. We got to call her.
Call you on the line with the Official Pushback Show. What's your name?
Hello?
Quickly call her.
Okay.
All right, I don't need you.
Yeah, but you need to get mic'd in. Kamila, is it Kamila? Y'all need to get together because we need to get the vocal cords together.
Ooh, Trey, stop.
Everybody's like,
he's no item. Please don't like him. He don't wife him. He won't nice him.
I never listen, though. I don't know the rest of the movie.
You was irritating, boy.
Right,
yeah, but let's get this together, and that's going to wrap it up for us, people.
Woo, Jesus.
Tune in next week, same station, same time, for more Prevention Radio.
Shout out to everybody who has courage to just say no.
Shout out to everyone who has courage to stay drug free. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Steps Radio. And hey, prevention works.
Steps Radio, we need more followers. You've been hanging in the studio with
Imani,
Trey,
Nakaya,
India,
and the Prevention Man. Say no to drugs
and yes to God. Good night.
Thanks for tuning in. Keep it official. It's the real Pushback Radio.
Don't believe it, just watch.
I definitely want to say thanks to Micah
and Kamila.
You got to have you guys back. Yes, get them a big hand. Big hand. They did good.
Wait a minute. Put some liquor in it. No, don't do that. We drug and
right.
thug free.
And drug free.
That's not
and liquor free.
That's not steps.
Right. We don't the National Council on Alcohol and Drug Dependency.
Right.
Dependent on alcohol and drugs. That's
yeah,
not
all
steps.
Y'all out there all who strung out on drugs, you know, alcoholics, call steps.
Ooh, I NCADD. Hold on. Wait a minute.
Follow me on Instagram. Can I do it?
Follow me on Instagram at triple.itrip.
Ooh, follow me on Instagram at Pretty K.
5K. Four underscores. 5.1, you know.
Four underscores Pretty K. Oh, wait.
Everybody know you.
Follow Steps. At Steps Radio.
Okay, Trey. Don't hate.
Let them say something real fast. Running up out of here. Got 10 seconds. Got 3.
Follow me on Instagram at Kamila underscore peoples.
Follow me on All Eyes on Mike. All underscores. Bye.
Goodbye.
Thank you guys for coming out.
America. I'm happy to be drug and drug free.
Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, 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 oh.
Before we leave, let me tell y'all a little something. Uptown, funk you up.
Uptown,
funk you up.
I think it was too bad.
Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. I said uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up.
You've been listening to The Official Pushback on 1440 WDRJ, Tuesdays at 7 p.m. NCAT GDA Steps Radio is a listener-supported show for and by young people. To join us in this community effort, please consider making a tax-deductible donation to The Official Pushback Radio broadcast by logging onto the net at stepstoday.wix.com/stepsradio. That's STEPS, the number 2, DAY, .WIX.com/stepsradio. Or call our offices at 313-868-1340, extension 109. Be blessed.
Gospel 1440 AM is WMKM, Inkster, Detroit. Welcome back to the family.
Pray
Praise the Lord and welcome to the Precious Diamond Radio Ministry, where I am your host, Prophetess Davine Precious Sires. Elder Bendu Reeves Green is the co-host. You can listen to the Precious Diamond Radio Ministry, which is a prophetic ministry through biblical application, right here at WDRJ 1440 AM every Tuesday evening from 8 p.m. to 8:30 p.m.